Foodie Films. There was a foodie who embarked on a foodie adventure. There were restaurants everywhere. Ate food. Great desserts. Amazing restaurants. All new in Nagoya, Japan, where food and love collided, and all her foodie dreams came true. Restaurants will be scored with the FFOODEEZZ AdFUNturez page. They will be based on cleanliness, decor, service, flavor, and appropriate spiciness, with a bonus category for anything exceptionally well done. A 1 to 3 on each category will be given. 1 is below average, 2 is average, and 3 is above average. Thank you for watching. One more time, this is Foodie AdFUNturez with Joe Nini. Please like and subscribe. Okay, with no further ado. Okay, hello, hello, greetings everyone. How do you do? Well, I'm out. And it's freezing cold, but I'm going for a foodie adventure. I am out in front of Mega Indian Steakhouse. Actually, my friend recommended it to me and told me to check it out. So this is the front of the building. Hello, hello. So I'm here and I was seated, and the waitress, she came and she sat next to me and she read me the menu, because this menu has no English, and she used her iPhone to assist her. So she just took out her iPhone and she asked me questions and I read the English off her iPhone. So this is a steakhouse. It has mostly just a steak menu, or meat, I would say, not just steak, but meat. And for example, there's the beef. And she told me you choose what meat and the portion size you want. For example, 180 grams, 200 grams. And she showed me the picture. That's the meat. And she was able to tell me meat page. For example, she told me this is the pork, and you must choose which pork you want, and then choose the portion size. For example, right here it says 150, and the price is 1,630 grams. And there is sausage, chicken, and everything. So it's very nice, interesting restaurant. And she told me this is only meat. So the process here is you choose the meat size and the portion. These are the party platters right here. And then after you choose your meat, you can decide the salad bar. Here's the salad bar, and you can choose the drink bar. So I did add the salad bar and the drink bar, and I chose the hamburg steak right here. The hamburg steak is like a Salisbury steak in America. So very interesting process. Shortly after, she brought me out two bowls. This bowl, she told me, is for the raw vegetables. And this bowl is for the grilled vegetables. So she assisted me. Very nice. Okay, so she just brought me out my Salzburg steak. This plate in the middle of the table is hot. When I first sat down, she told me, this is hot. Please be careful. So I'm sitting at the table, and this is a hot plate right here. This is my plate with the Salzburg steak. And she told me to place my meat on the grill and just grill it how much I want. So this is like a self-serve. Okay, so I have my raw vegetables, and as I sat down, she came and instructed me. She told me I can cook my raw vegetables on this grill in front of me. So I think I'll do that. Let's see. And this is a little bit nerve-wracking for me when I go to a new restaurant, because sometimes they're really accommodating and welcoming, and sometimes I get the impression that they don't want to be bothered. So I'm really excited that she just gave me the extra care. It's really nice. So I love eggplant, so I have my eggplant, and I'm putting it on the grill. Eggplant, some peppers, and I will just grill it myself. Having another foodie adventure, so yes, the menu has quite a few meat items. It's good for meat lovers. They do have a child menu. I will show you the clip for the child menu. And this is a chain. So this is a chain restaurant in Japan. Right now I am a little bit in the countryside in Tokushige area. So this Indian steakhouse is huge, and it has a kids playland, but the one that I seen in the city, in the center of the city, it did not have a big playland. So that's pretty good for people with children to come out and they have a playland. Okay, and you hear the country music.
Soon I'll be back in old family shack.
It actually smells good. I'm over here just cooking away. Pretty fun. And Ida, okay, so it says salt, pepper. This says shoyu. I only can read a little bit of Japanese. Shoyu, which is soy sauce. And this is like a Salisbury steak. It has my little sauce. The meat, when she brought it out to me, it was very rare. And so she said, I can just cook it to my liking. So why not? If you are a rare meat person, you can get very rare meat in the menu. And I'll have to tell you, sometimes in Japan, you look at the menu and it will be a picture of raw meat. So, of course, I figured, oh, this is what the meat looks like. And then you'll come in and you'll cook it yourself like here. But that's not always the case. Sometimes the picture is raw meat and they will give you the raw meat. And people eat it like the sushi, but instead of it being fish, they'll have it like steak or chicken or horse meat. So it's just good to know. And COVID is still in effect here, so it's not that many people. So that, like what I was saying, sorry, I got sidetracked. But yeah, sometimes you can get the very rare meat and it has an egg on it. Where is the menu? And the menu is underneath the seat. So just like the picture I showed you, you can have meat just like that. And that's great for people. You have a variety here. Ooh, my eggplant looks great. I love eggplant. And a lot of my friends don't like eggplant. I was cooking gourmet eggplant for our dinner parties. And I was the only one eating the eggplant, so. Over here cooking. Eggplant looks good. The bell pepper looks great. I think these are cooking chopsticks because they are a little bit bigger. I'm not sure though. I'm not 100% sure, okay? So. Happy birthday, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. And I have cucumber at the bottom. The Japanese cucumbers taste so good here. It's a different flavor. Oh. Delicious, crispy, fresh, organic, and they're smaller. Okay, so I asked her, I wasn't sure which meal package set I ordered. So I know I ordered the salad bar, but I wasn't sure if the rice came with the salad bar. So I had to ask her, and she told me I can get rice and I can get soup. So I guess I got the everything, because everything's separate here. You order your meat, and then you order your salad bar, and I guess it's a only salad or only rice or what have you. So I'm going to go get my rice, and I will try my food. Right back. Okay, so I have my soup and my rice, and I finished cooking my meat. I did ask what kind of soup. She told me vegetable soup. That's all I got. It looks like just a broth, and I see bean sprouts and onions. Very simple soup. So I know some people want to know exactly every detail. Here, I'm a little bit flexible. I don't really have any allergies or food constraints, but if you are, you would probably want to go to a place which is more accommodating for foreigners. So, I have my soup and my rice and my meat, and I'm ready to dig in. The meat tastes pretty seasoned for what they gave it to me. It's it reminds me of maybe seasoning salt, hamburger meat. But it's still tasty and delicious. Nice fresh meat. And the rice was self-served. I will show you the pot of rice. Just a huge pot of rice, and it's self-served. The soup was self-served. Very easy. I am pleased with my dish, so very nice. And the soup, yeah, tastes like a basic chicken broth with some Japanese vegetables, bean sprouts, and onions. Not nothing special, but it is good for a nice hot day. I mean, not hot day, a nice cold day. I have a beanie on. Sorry. This was a nice treat. So, excuse me, but I didn't eat today. So I got some more vegetables for the grill and another soup. And as I got more into the soup, I realized there is some seaweed and little bits of steak at the bottom of the soup. So what a pleasure surprise! Pleasurable surprise! Eggplant. Oh my goodness. Oh The sauce actually is a little sweet and savory. I would say spicy sweet. But extremely delicious. Okay, so I finished my meal. It was really nice. So let me do my foodie adventures faces. If I could find my pin. Oh, I found a blue pin. So cleanliness. Above average cleanliness. Decor, simple decor, which you would expect for a place that has kids. So I'll give it a 2 out of 3. Service, exceptional service. I mean, she sat here and she took her time to explain the menu to me. And she used her phone to translate because she didn't know English. And my Japanese is I can say 1 or 2 words at a time. So definitely 3 out of 3. Flavor, good flavor. Average, above average. I'll say above average. It was nice, hearty meat. Spiciness, normal, average. Bonus. I'll give them a bonus because I believe this would be a great place if you're with children or you're traveling. I mean, totally relaxed environment. Dun, dun, dun. So the total, let's see. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 out of 15. For what is it called? Indian Steakhouse or Mega Indian Steakhouse. Yes. I definitely would bring someone here if they were a big meat eater. I mean, the platters, they had big, big platters, $50, $60 full of meat, steak, pork, sausages. If you are a hearty meat eater, for sure. Anything else? They're also, she asked me, they have a table area. I'm in the table area, and they do have a bar area on the other end. So they do also have a bar area. Okay. Anything else? Oh, my meal total was about $13. So I ordered my hamburger meat steak and my vegetables. So very nice. All right. Thank you. If you enjoy my videos or you have a request or a question, please don't hesitate to send me a message in the comments or you can send a private message if you like. All right. This is Joe Nini. And oh, I forgot. Thank you, Hideki, for your recommendation. I had to tell everyone out there in TV land, thank you. It's great. Yes, eat well, my friends, and show me some love. And push that thumbs up and subscribe. Okay, until next time. Ta-ta. Bye, and thank you. Of course, I had to play in the play area one time. Ta-ta.